Okay. Let's get started. How was lunch? Edible? Good. Good. Thumbs up from Jani, so I guess it's very good. Just add bacon, right? I think best conference chicken ever because of the bacon, right? Great. So for the afternoon, we have even more sessions going, I would say, deeper and deeper all the way once we go down under with Dan. And we'll start with Johan talking about Azure Site Recovery and then some. Right? All right. Stage is yours.
Thank you very much. So hopefully everybody had got a good lunch. For now, we will start, if the screen is there, with Azure Site Recovery, Business Continuity, Migrations and Assessments in 60 minutes. My name is Johan Bieren. I work at Inspark in the Azure team as Principal Consultant. And you can reach me on Twitter. And I'm blogging on talkingazure.com. The agenda for the couple of 60 minutes is an introduction to Azure Site Recovery to give you all a good overview of Microsoft Business Continuity and Disaster Recovery solutions, some scenarios, and we will give you some Azure Site Recovery demos, and then we go deeper in the services of Microsoft. After that, we go to Azure Migrate and an introduction to Azure Migrate. What is it? And after that, we do also some demos about Hyper-V assessments. I've got my data center in the pocket here at the front to give you an explanation about Hyper-V assessments and do a demo with Azure Migrate. What's driving customers to migrate to Azure based on business continuity and disaster recovery? Some triggers. Data center lease renewal, capacity crisis. At the lunch, I talked with some people, and when the data center is full and some new project will start, then they have to wait a couple of months when the new hardware is delivered. So then you've got crisis. Hardware and software refresh, getting solutions to market faster. When you are in Azure, your releases will be much faster if you implement it the correct way. Some value, economics about CapEx and OpEx, when you need to develop it and when you have got some investments back, and global scalability about security. So mostly in data centers, the security part can be tricky. In Azure, you've got tons of services that will help you to get better with your security requirements. Some enablers, the workload and process guidance, and migration tools, what Microsoft offers. Later in the demos, I will show you the tools that are available from Microsoft and their partners. Choose of tools for every stage and every requirement is available. Today, we talk about assessments, migrations, but you also need to optimize and secure and manage your environment. Xiaoqi already told you about blueprints and Azure policies, but today I will show you how you assess and migrate your environment with Azure Migrate in combination with Azure Site Recovery. Some cloud migration strategies is the rehosting, the refactor, re-architect, and rebuild. When you want to redeploy as it is in the cloud, that's where we're talking about over today, is about IaaS components. Azure Site Recovery in combination with disaster recovery, it will reduce your CapEx and free up data center spaces. Refactor, when you lift and shift your environment to the Azure environment, it's not always a good choice to only migrate your VMs. But for example, if you've got SQL environments, you can go to PaaS services. Or when you host app services, You can go to containers and app services itself. After that, you can re-architect your environment or completely rebuild your code. But today we talk about rehosting. Some business challenges, what I came from the field, is customers need to reduce their cost and related to their downtime. When a failover or disaster recovery is planned, or it's happened, hopefully it will not happen, today the cost will be higher if they've got not the correct solution for this. Constant monitoring of services can be a challenge. When you're in your on-prem environment with Hyper-V or VMware, it could be a challenge to monitor your complete environment. And manual recovery of many virtual machines that compose services, it could be complex, and it could be also time-consuming, because you've got almost too much complexity, and you also need to hire some specialized human involvement, and you want to automate that kind of processes. And there is a lack of real-world disaster management experience. That's the recovery part. We can also we've also got a challenge about protecting many workloads. Some workloads that could be benefit from protecting unprotected to doing cost complexity. If you've got two data centers, for example, and you need to fail over, and the other data center has got not enough resources, because in your first primary data center, a lot of projects are starting, a lot of resources are consuming, then the second data center could be having problems about resources. Recovery and protecting your applications. Orchestrating and recovering your apps for simplified disaster recovery could be a challenge, and we can orchestrate that in Microsoft Azure. And what we want to improve is the RTO and RPO time based on planned and unplanned outages. Achieve zero impact about disaster recovery drills. When we move to the cloud or do a disaster recovery drill, you don't want to have much timeout. Based on that, I will show in the demo, we can solve that. And we want to replicate all types of environment like Hyper-V, VMware, cloud, and other physical environments. What I want to give you is that we want to leave the old. And for example, when you host your environment in your Hyper-V environment or in your VMware or physical machines, data center recovery and migrations, we are using a lot of time, and we are using it a longer time, a couple of years, and we want to go to the new. As you migrate and site recovery, I see that is the is a complete disaster recovery solution and migration solution for your requirements. Now, a little bit an explanation, and later more, is what we can do with Azure Site Recovery is that we can do a site to Azure or site to site. We can migrate or synchronize from AWS to Azure, or from VMware to Azure, and also from Hyper-V to Hyper-V, or from a physical machine to Hyper-V with Virtual Machine Manager. And physical VMware to another VMware cluster. So when you have got multiple data centers, you can synchronize those workloads with Azure Site Recovery. And any OS, also Linux and Windows, can be replicated. An eye overview of some scenarios is what we come with some customers is that they have got still 2008 Windows servers. The right migration tool we can use for that is Azure Site Recovery. And if we want to plan large-scale VMware migrations, then Azure Site Recovery in combination with Azure Migrate is the right tool for that kind of specific scenarios. We don't talk about today about database migration service, but I put it in the slide, is that if we want to migrate SQL environments, then we can use the database migration service, online and offline migration, with that specific scenario. There are some features still in preview, but production deployments are supported. Some large-scale VMware assessments, for example. If we want to assess your complete VMware environment, we can assess with one assessment machine 10,000 of servers in one assessment. And for Hyper-V assessments, that's currently 5,000 servers. What's also new is agentless migrations from VMware to Azure. A couple of months ago, we still need to install agents on the servers. And now it's possible to not completely agentless, because you always have to implement, and that we come in a couple of seconds in the next slides, a machine and an agent on it to connect to your Hyper-V or ASX host, vCenter. But within the virtual machines itself, you don't need any agents anymore. Some solutions for multiple infrastructures is what you see is we can go from Hyper-V to Hyper-V. You have to do it with Virtual Machine Manager in combination with Azure Site Recovery. You can do also SAN-to-SAN replicates with Hyper-V on-premise, Hyper-V to Azure, VMware physical to VMware, and replicate your VMware physical to Microsoft Azure. And what's also possible is for disaster recovery and also for migrations, Azure to Azure. Now, how does site recovery in high overview works? That you see over here, today we talk about Hyper-V, but VMware is also possible on physical servers. You've got a couple of servers you need to install within your on-prem environment, a process server, a configuration server, and a mobility service. And the process server, in my opinion, is the most important server, because that server will process all your machines that need to be replicated. It goes over a data channel. It can be end-to-end encrypted over SSL on the internet, but there are companies that will not allow you to transfer your workloads directly over the internet. It is encrypted. You can also use public peering. Nowadays, it's called Microsoft peering. And to go over your express route to synchronize your workloads. You have to do some additional steps based on some dynamic routing. And with Hyper-V, you directly install a Microsoft Azure Recovery Service agent. So that's the only agent you need in an appliance. And then you can synchronize exactly the same over the internet or over your express route. Both are secure, but for different requirements, you can implement different solutions. This S3 recovery as a service for hosted workloads is when you have your data center on-prem, you've got an extensible data channel to Azure. And when you are in Azure, you can also sync it to other regions within Azure. When we've got a second data center or a third, but you can also call it a plant. So in a couple of weeks, we did a project. And they've got some plants all over the world with a couple of servers in it, 3, 4, 5 servers and a plant. And they are now, synchronizing disaster recovery their workloads to Azure and not anymore over the MPLS line to their on-prem environment or to needs to be extra hardware on the location itself. So multiple locations can be synchronized to Azure. Disaster recovery migration strategy is I defined a couple of stages, and the first is assess your environment. You've got some steps to do, is plan your infrastructure. When you assess your environment, you can see a clear overview about the assessments. In the demo, I will show it to you. Prepare the on-premise site. You need to set up a recovery vault. Set up and register the appliance that you will install. Then you are ready to discover and assess. And then you've got also, in a couple of minutes or a couple of days, your business case. The migration itself, you need a migration server, migration process, then you will install the agents when necessary or if not. Then you can do a migration test, and then you can migrate or disaster recovery your workloads. The last thing is business continuity and disaster recovery. Is based on the assessment and continuous discovery, we can do test failovers and also plant failovers if necessary. And then your complete solution, disaster recovery and migrations are all in one strategy. And it is secure by design. Recovery vault and the synchronization to Azure is completely secured. And it is self-service, and we can automate this complete process, what I'll show you in the demo. Before we go to the demo, a couple of information is with Azure Site Recovery, you can have consistent experience. There's one central place to manage your complete environment. And Microsoft is doing hard work to put all these Azure Site Recovery components to Azure Migrate, what I will show to you. But Azure Site Recovery is the belying technology from Azure Migrate. It's a streamlined configuration, step by step. It supports different kind of recovery points. You can configure your synchronization, how much time you need to have for your RTO and RPO. Based on your, what's an important thing is your internet connectivity from the data center itself. If you got a 100 Mbit line with a couple of 100 servers, for example, then you need a good internet outbound line from out your data center. Network mapping is one we want to fail over. Network mapping is fully integrated. We can choose when we fail over, what kind of network your components need to be in. And what you see over here is the site recovery policy and the retention policy. If this is the source type, Hyper-V. We can copy the frequency 5 minutes. We can also do recovery time retention for 2 hours, and that is all from one single console. And what you see also is Azure's Hyper-V sites. That are your data centers, and you can configure as many sites if you want. What we can also do in Azure Site Recovery is create recovery plans and flexible failover fallback options. We can automate this this completely, also with post scripts and other kind of scripts based on automation accounts. So when you fail over or when you migrate your services to Azure and you need to deinstall, for example, your VMware agents or remove your antivirus solutions because you want to use the, for example, the Microsoft solutions, then you don't want to do that for 100 or 200 or 300 VMs, then we can automate it with automation accounts. Business continuity. I think you are all familiar with availability from a single VM. We can use premium storage. Within one data center of Microsoft, we can use availability sets. In one region, we can use availability zones for network and power outages inside the data center. But when a region will fail out, we can use Azure Site Recovery with the region pairs. For example, West Europe and North Europe, we can set up Azure Site Recovery to sync the VMs to the second region. Including Zona support. Now we go to the demo, and there I will show you how Azure Site Recovery works within Hyper-V to Azure and Azure to Azure. And I'll let walk you through how it works. That screen. I prepared something, that is the recovery vault. And within the recovery vault, if you want to implement Azure Site Recovery, for migrations or disaster recovery, first of all, you need to set up your infrastructure. Now, within your infrastructure, you've got a couple of options. You see, for Azure Virtual Machines, for VMware and physical machines, and for System Center VMM, and below, for Hyper-V. Now, you see a couple of things, Hyper-V sites, Hyper-V host, and replication policies. What you see here is my Hyper-V site. Here at here below, I've got my data center, and that's my Hyper-V site one. And it's called demo server, and there are two protected VMs in it. So if you set up a new site, you can give it a name, and based on your replication policies, you can implement, you can apply your site. We go below, you see also your Hyper-V host. That's that thing, and it's connected, and you can also see the agent version and the protected items, and you can renew your certificates from here. And the last thing is the replication policy. What I want to show to you. Is what you see over here. We've got a source type is Hyper-V. It can also be VMware. It's connected to Azure. And let's go to the settings. I've got now a copy frequency of 5 minutes, but we can also use 30 seconds. App consistency snapshots is the frequency at which your application consists a snapshot, the max of 12. And when we replicate the first machine, we can also plan based on offline hours to replicate your VM to Azure. Let's go to the recovery folder again. And then to site recovery. First, I want to show you the Azure part. And you see, I've got a couple of critical VMs because the internet connection is not so bad, so it will not replicate my VMs. But I did it yesterday when I was at home. You see here, Azure machines, VMware machines, and Hyper-V. First of all, we go to Azure Virtual Machines. What you see over here, and that's also the cost factor, is we've got two virtual machines protected. We've got a cache storage account. And we've got Azure Site Recovery. You only pay in the second region for your storage cost. So when a failover will happen, then the VM will spin up. And then you also pay for the VM that's located in the other region. And then you can shut down your VM, or it will happen that your VM is getting shut down at the other side. You see here that two VMs are replicated in Azure. They are now active location is North Europe. And what I want to show to you is this machine. We can fail over, we can do a test failover. For disaster recovery drills or for migration drills, you can do a test failover. And if you see, if Azure is working with us, in a couple of seconds, then we also go open a second screen. There it is that I want to fail over the direction from North Europe to West Europe. And you can see here is my latest recovery point or my latest app consistency snapshot. Now let's choose this one, or we can also use a custom. Then we go back in time if you want. But I don't want to use a custom now. And you can select your virtual network. Be careful of this. Always choose a virtual network because choose a virtual network that is not connected to your other virtual network. So not a peering, for example, because when your virtual machine will become up in this network and there is a peering to the other virtual network, then you can have got some conflicts. So create an empty VNet for this. And you see it also here. It's recommended for test failovers to use a network different from a production network. Now the test failover will start. In a couple of seconds, you see the that the test failover, and you can test your application. And over here, we will also open the other virtual machine that's located in Azure. And there we want to plan a failover. And let's see what's happening over here. If we go to virtual machines, it's not there yet. And also do a complete failover to West Europe and shut down the virtual machine before beginning for failover. And that also will start. We come back to this because it is creating now the virtual machine at the back. If we go back to our recovery fault, then you can also see over here. So we now do it a manual failover. You can also do it with Hyper-V. And in there, you see I've got my Hyper-V environment, and it's now in a critical state. And over here, we can do exactly the same. So we can fail over or migrate the workload that's located in my data center to Azure. And we can also do test failovers. So if you want to test your migration, just do a test failover, and you can connect to the virtual machine based with their internal IP to test if your application is fully working. We got also got some properties that we can check. And this is the target location. My mouse is not working. Yeah. The compute and disk that will be available at the other side. But what we can also do is when on the on-premise environment, my machine is called PolarConf F02. We can also use another name in Azure based on your naming convention in Azure, and then you can change all the settings and also the size of your virtual machine. Later, with the assessment, you can use this. Or you can change your virtual network where your machine must be re-replicated in. You can also change your hybrid benefits if you've got your license available. But what we can also do is see the disk configuration that's now replicated. If we go back to the recovery vault, then is the next step what I want to show you are recovery plans to do some automation. Because you don't want to fail over your applications. Is what you see over here is that I've got one source and the settings in this, there's now only one item in this plan. But when you've got an application set, so a couple of servers that's hosting your application, you can customize this. You can also fail over the complete group. So there's now one machine in it, but if you've got multiple machines that are need to be protected together, then we can also add, for example, the second machine. And the most important thing, what we can also do here, is automation stuff. Let's wait when this is changed. Yep. It's called add pre-actions or add post-actions. Now, pre-actions, you can do before a failover will start. Then you can call it a name. You've got an automation account. And for this demo, I picked up two runbooks, the pre-migration runbook, or you can define what you want in your runbook. If you want to disable your agent inside your VM, or you want some other stuff, or you want to apply some extensions to your VM when it's failovered, then you can do it by automation in your runbooks. Now, if you do now a test failover or a complete failover, the complete group will failover. No manual machines will failover, the complete group. Let's go back to the presentation, if I can find my mouse. Some architecture. What you see over here is the on-premise environment. Your source environment is East US, and Azure Site Recovery Service extensions are automatically installed on the VM. What's also available right now is when you replicate your VMs between Azure, if you add extensions with your automation account, the extensions will be synchronized to the second region. A continuous replication begins for the VM. Disk writes are immediately transferred to the cache storage account in the source location. And site recovery process, the data cache sends data to the target account, and it replicates the disks. So you will not, what I mentioned earlier, the VMs itself. This is another situation. What you see over here is your web front-end environment with a traffic manager before. And you've got a not SQL PaaS environment, but with SQL availability groups. What you see over here is that with asynchron synchronization, when this complete environment is down, your SQL availability cluster brings up this instance. And you, when you replicate your web service, it will become available in the secondary region. Based on automation, you can change with your traffic manager, your endpoints, and your DNS settings. Azure Migrate, what does it do? Easily discover of your on-premise virtual machines. This also directly a migration and test migration tool. Microsoft has implement Azure Site Recovery and replication process now inside also Azure Migrate. It visualizes dependencies to create move groups. So you get a few clear sight what the dependencies are of your virtual machines and your applications. It will show you in the demo. Inside, you've got a suitable analyze, and you can edit the analyze. So if you've got your enterprise agreement subscription, and you've got some discount or other requirements, you can edit. Right-sized Azure resources based on utilization history. If you assess your environment in 1 day, it will give you an eye overview of the cost. If you were on it for a week, for example, then you get a better better assessment. And it also now supports for VMware and agentless with Hyper-V. And as you migrate, there are no costs for it. Now, what can it do? It can assess VMware and Hyper-V assessments. What also mentioned earlier is that it can scale up for 5,000 VMs in Hyper-V and 10,000 VMs now in VMware. It's completely agentless, and it has got fully integrated services. And there are four steps to migrate to use it. Is first of all, discover and assess. Create and review your assessment. Report and analyze your assessment. together with your business. And after that, you can create business cases and you can plan your migration. Now, this is an overview how the process works. I also show it to you. Is that we've got the customer or the consultant is download and configure the appliance within your VMware environment or Hyper-V host. It's just a VAD format that you can insert in your Hyper-V host. It needs some ports open, or within vCenter to your ASX host with some permissions, and your discovery will start over the internet to the discovery service, and after that you can create your assessment and directly start your replication from Azure Migrate. The second demo I want to show you about Azure Migrate and the assessments. Let's go back. Oh, maybe the failover is now completed. Show it to you. Ah, yes. This was a test failover. And what you see over here is that there's test at the end. And now the virtual machine is completely up and running, and your application is migrated from your Hyper-V host or your VMware environment to Azure with a test migration. You can also easily, to let it show it to you, we go back to the recovery vault before we go to Azure Migrate. Was an Azure virtual machine, I guess. Yeah, over here. When we tested our failover, you can also easily clean up your test failover, give it your reason why, and then click OK. And now the virtual machine will be deleted when you've tested your complete application. Now let's go on with Azure Migrate. What you see over here is that Microsoft is integrating their replication and migration strategy in one service. You can see it over here. Migrate your on-premise data center to Azure. Discovery and assess service. From this portal, you can also assess and migrate your databases. Assess and migrate your web apps on-prem. If you've got IIS sites, you can easily assess those sites if they are ready for app services or are they ready for containers. And migrate on-premise data to Azure, for example, with Azure Data Box. But for now, we will do the assessment based on service. And what you have to do, and what I already prepared, and at the end of the session, I will connect this data center in the box to the HDMI cable to show you the Hyper-V environment. But for now, I've created a project over here. Create here to make a new project. You have to give it the project name. In Europe. And what we can also see over here, we now will use Azure Migrate, but there are also other tools available, such as CloudOmise, Cloud Assessments, Corent. But for now, we will use Azure Migrate. So there are also other tools available. The Select the Migration tool, we will use Azure Migrate. But there are also some other tools available from the Azure environment. And you see also the supported workloads and the features that are in it. And if you click on Learn More, then you see exactly what. So for now, we create a new project. And when the project is created, I will change to another one that I also created, is that you see you can discover your VM. To discover your VM, you need to download an appliance for VMware or for Hyper-V. I use Hyper-V. If you download the Azure Migration Appliance, you can import it in your VMware cluster or your VMware host. That I already did. Where's the rest of the screen? Then I will go to the project that I already finished. And what you can see over here is that I imported the appliance in my Hyper-V host. This is my appliance name, and the discovery agent and the assessment agent is connected to it. If we go to create an assessment, here over here, I already create one. Then you see I need to recalculate it because this assessment is out of date. And then you see exactly in one overview what is Azure Readiness. Now, the three virtual machines that are hosted in my Hyper-V host are ready with some conditions. And you see already the monthly cost, what it will be in Azure. Let's wait a couple of seconds. Assessment is ready. Yeah, it's ready now. What you can also do before we click on it is export the assessment. Creating an Excel file for you. When it's open. In this screen now. You can see all the information about the subscription, about the VMs, but also the information what you see in the portal. So this could be handy for your business case to explain it to your colleagues. But what you see over here in the portal itself is what is ready for Azure and what not. If we click one VM, then you see I've got an unsupported boot type. But when we migrate, we do a test failover, then Microsoft Azure Site Recovery converts the boot type during the migration, for example. If we open another one, and you see all the information about the assessment of my VM itself. We can also edit the properties because you sum some costs. And here we can change almost anything. The VM size, for example, performance history, you get a better overview when we do it for 1 week. Which VM series do you apply to the Azure environment? Some pricing, I do it in euros. If you've got discount for Microsoft, you can also put it in here. And the offer type, I now have a pay-as-you-go, but you can also pick another offer. And if you want to use hybrid benefits, then it's also available. Based on this, we can also create groups. So group applications together. And what we can also see here is that we can see the dependencies. but my VMs are now down, so I can't see the dependencies. And what I want to show you is a graph that exactly shows you what kind of dependencies there are and what kind of phasing endpoints there are inbound and outbound available from your machine and what dependencies it have with other machines. So based on the assessment, it analyzed the dependencies with other machines, and based on that, you can create groups to migrate it to Azure if you got no idea what applications, what servers are communicating with each other. And what you can also see over here is when I open the other project, you can directly discover your VMs, just like Azure Site Recovery, use your target region, but and then you can do your migrations also from Azure Site, from Azure Migrate itself. So when this is ready, I think this will fail because there's no host connected to this project. And this is the complete overview of my assessment. Then you see exactly how much VMs there are in the assessment and they are discovered. Ah, we see here the dependencies. I don't know if it is available. Yeah. This is the map I want to show you. And then you can see exactly, this is now one VM, but you can exactly what kind of ports are exposed to the outside from your applications. And when you've got selected multiple machines, you can also see the connections between the VMs. Go back here, and at the end, if we've got time left, I will show you the appliance itself. A little summary is Azure Site Recovery is not the only part of disaster recovery and business continuity suite. There are a lot of other products available, what you see in the migration suite. It is important to classify your workloads based on your RTO and RPO needs. Based on that, you can implement Site Recovery and Azure Migrate. What Microsoft is doing is that it brings it all together in one portal. So not all the functionalities are in Azure Migrate, but it's a good start. And from there, you can define your process about a better disaster recovery or to migrate your workloads. What's important is that on-prem, you don't run disaster recovery drills, or it can be hard. And within Azure Site Recovery, you can test your disaster recovery drills or your test failovers. And concerns about security issues like malware and ransomware when they are in your site, your service, you can also go back to another RTO time to restore your complete VM. The last thing, if it is working, I want to show you the Hyper-V host itself. Then you can see the assessment tooling. One moment, because we can't RDP, make a remote desktop connection to it. Let's see, yeah. I've got here my my data center, my Hyper-V host. And what you see over here, if you are familiar with Hyper-V, and you can see that this VM also in the Azure portal is replicating. And you can see here replicating changes. It's now for 69%. That's the first time in this day. Better internet connection today. And what you can also see is the replication health. You can see it also in the Azure portal, but also from here. Ah, and for the first time it replicated here in Helsinki with this internet connection. So you see over here that your VMs are replicated. I've imported two appliances. The first one is already connected to a project. Let's open it. So when you import the downloaded appliance, then you need to walk through some steps. And let's see if this will work, if we've got internet connection. And let's also open the second appliance. This appliance, what I mentioned earlier, is doing the assessment itself. This is already pre-configured, so it's checking my internet connection, but it can take a long time. Not in your data center, but in this demo environment, it can take a long time. It's checking the time with the internet service. It's also checking the latest migration updates and your Hyper-V details, where you configure the connection to your host. You can add as much as possible host in this assessment if you want. There is only a limit based on the total machines you can assess. And take some time. So hopefully this is clear for you. You have to import this in your VMware or your Hyper-V host. Then you fill in all the details, like the username and password for your host. Let's try if it works. Now do it with administrator. It's not working now. But I think it's clear for you. And I now do it with the administrator account, but you can give a local user account some specific permissions to read your Hyper-V cluster. And then you can add your Hyper-V host or your clusters to discover. And then save and start discovery. That will happen in a couple of minutes. Let's go back to the other one. If that will succeed. Oh no, this is the right one. Put it in here. Let's see if this will work. Yep. Nope. That was my session for Azure Site Recovery and Azure Migrate. Thank you very much. And do you have got some questions about this topic? Hopefully it was clear for you what the possibilities are. And the next session is about troubleshooting Azure VMs by Alexander. So thank you very much.